So after seeing the contents of the title as regards gift, now we'll travel to the next title of law, and that is regarding master and servant. The name itself states us that this has to be in regard to the employer and employee. Wages, non-wages, payments, non-payment of wages. So let us see what are the contents of the topic or a title of law, master and servant. It is divided in three categories: breach of promised obedience. Now it says what should be done when a obedience is being promised and a breach takes place. Non-payment of wages. Now, if the work is being done and the master is not paying wages, what should be done is stated in this act. Disputes between owner and servant. Now, these are the disputes which occur. So, this particular topic, when we see and when we understand, in the first three categories, it speaks somewhere about disobedience, non-payments, and the disputes which occur between the master and the servant. Now, what is there after that? Relationship is for following causes. Now, it says, or in short, these are the valid relationships where the exchange of money can take place, or there is a possibility of payment of wages. Now, what are these relationships? Let us see them. For science. Now, science means studies. At that point of time, it were the ashrams which were termed as schools. So, this particular point means the Guru Shishya Parampara, the affection to the Guru and payback to the Guru. Then we have for skill. Now, for skill means this is regarding art and craft. There may be a person who may be an excellent sculptor, and he may have various juniors. So, this is nothing but a kind of an apprenticeship contract which prevails today. Because of love. Now, certain relationship exists because of love. But at the same time, they are also governed by the concept of master and servant. Hence, they are mentioned here. For gain. A relationship which is done, that is for gain. Two persons come together, decide a particular activity, and out of that particular activity, they will derive a benefit. So, that kind of a relationship for gain is a valid relationship. For share. Now, a relationship which is done to share the particular things. Now, here when we say for share, this share is different from partnership business. Apparently, they look to be same, but in factual position, they are not same. So, when we see this entire topic of master and servant, we get a feeling that the present day's industrial laws or payment of wages, all that is reflected when we see this ancient law. One factor which seems to be missing, or maybe an addition in our new law, is bonus. Because anywhere here, there is no concept of bonus which is being mentioned. So, these were the various ingredients of the law which regulated between the master and the servant.